Hello, everyone. This is the city of Bogota, where I grew up. And they promised me that it was going to look like that when I turned 20. But of course, that did not happen because it looks something like this. We humans are extremely weird. We create highly complex cities, but we struggle to do simple things like carrying a water bottle, right? So why? Why such a strange network of human brains that can do amazing stuff struggles to do something as simple and, right, intelligent as carrying a water bottle to work or turning off the water when you're brushing your teeth? Is that really intelligence? Is it reading a lot of climate books and trying to figure out the puzzle, doing the hard things that we need to do? I believe that we haven't solved the climate crisis because our intelligence is lazy. But you know what is not lazy? Artificial intelligence. I think that AI is a brain that is not lazy. And probably if you read all of these climate books, you're going to remember five things. But AI is going to probably remember them all and even create a new one. So the question is, how can artificial intelligence can help us figure out this climate puzzle? And I know some of you don't care. Like, in fact, 51% of people don't care about climate, which is really close to 52% of you that are not going to pay for a product like this, right? But I also know that we cannot make everyone a sustainability genius, and we have to do the work, because otherwise we're not going to solve the climate crisis. So it might not be possible to make everyone a genius in sustainability, but we might be able to recreate the sustainability intelligence that we need. Beyond the current applications of artificial intelligence, I am absolutely excited about the new services that are going to be created because of the revolution of AI. It's more than what everyone thinks it's going to be predicted. It's what are we going to do with it? What are the new jobs that are going to be created? And I think sustainability personal coaches are going to be a thing. The AI models that are going to be the most actually useful are the ones that are going to have more data. And health and sustainability has lots of data for us to go and structure and deliver to people. The whole idea is that I don't care if you care or not about sustainability. You just have to act correctly, convenience, with data. And you have to have AI that is aligned with sustainability values. Being able to solve the asynchronous of information between what we do daily and our planet is key to have that solar punk future that I was promised as a child. And we need that voice to tell us how to do it. My team and I created Clia for this. Clia is an AI-driven assistant that it's gonna help you every single day to choose better. Basically, dynamic prices based on where the product is made or when it expires, having the carbon footprint of each product and being able to measure the water footprint that it has or the energy, those are information that we don't have when we buy things. And it's because before, we didn't have the cost, the marginal cost of computational capacity to get there. But today, things are different. We have the marginal cost of energy and computation almost going to zero. So we can do and afford to do things like this. But the tool that we created, of course, needs people to be prepared for it. And I know that. And I think that we can learn from what we do with athletes to get there. Because our approach to sustainability is probably not the best one. We need to find the key performance indicators. We need to find the machines, the equipments, the community, everything built up so that we can understand our approach of sustainability as something for us to take care about. Not something that I don't do because I don't care or it's super hard to do. We need to elevate that experience. And Clia is just really good at doing that. If we measure the benefits correctly and we simplify the actions, everyone would have the opportunity to act correctly. And in something as simple as what I just said, we have the potential to reduce gigatons of carbon dioxide if we change the way we consume through artificial intelligence. And when Clia is able to learn about your consumption habits and it's able to give you recommendations that are personalized to you and what you did today based on what you bought yesterday and what you're going to do tomorrow or where you are going, then you're going to choose better, which is what we ultimately need. What you do, it's ultimately a projection of what you believe and the information that's in front of you, and we can notch that and we can model that, and if we have a lot of computation, we can solve the crisis and have the Amazon rainforest back in Colombia, right? So I believe that a lazy human being, yes, will struggle to do that, but artificial general intelligence is not about what it's going to be replaced or, you know, what we can humans do. It's about what we are too lazy to do, right? It's about what we cannot do. And I believe that's the future we need to build. Health is all about wellness. And I believe wellness is super important in the future. AI needs to help everyone to choose better. And that's it. It's basically a billion choices can change gigatons of CO2. Artificial intelligence is perhaps that best friend that we all need. But most importantly, the one that's telling us what to do in alignment with our sustainability values. Thank you.